It's Linda Cromar. I'm coming to you from my home office in Colorado. I've been doing a bunch of redoing of my blog, lindacromar.com. Now you can see that I have written it out in longhand on my description and title, and the reason why is because Facebook blocks it if I put my actual link there. So there's nothing wrong with my link. It's just that they've decided that it's against the rules to put a simple blog up on Facebook. Now, here's what I recommend you do instead. I think Facebook is actually cracking down on links on Facebook. Eventually, that'll happen to all of you. What I recommend that you actually do is to learn to share. Sorry about that. Good quality. I don't know why I have a tickle. It's not because I'm sick. It's because whenever my throat gets dry, it causes me to cough. Oh, I might have to start over. Anyway, please forgive that. But what I have learned is that Facebook is trying to crack down on links. I think it's going to happen to all of you eventually. Now, I see a lot of people, especially brand new people, that are always trying to put their link directly on Facebook and share it all over. And what I'm going to tell you is that I think that Facebook doesn't like that. It really doesn't want you to try to draw people away from Facebook. They want you to stay on Facebook forever. They don't want you to move. They don't want you to change. They don't want you to go anywhere. Even when I was doing paid ads, I would often have times when it didn't like my Facebook, when I would take them off my Facebook and take them somewhere else. Now, I know you can mask it, but that's not really the issue. The issue is it's better to learn to share things without links. Now, let me tell you, I had a nice conversation with somebody, and he might even know who I'm talking about, yesterday. And he wanted to share his business, which is an MLM business. I'm not going to say what name it is. And eventually the way he talked was very inviting. Now, I'm not necessarily going to join that company, but what I do like is that when somebody is actually making friends and doing it the right way, and they can invite you to something without giving you a link. And when you are given an invitation that's friendly and not pushy, and they give you the opportunity to make a choice whether you're interested or not, guess what? I bet you're more interested. How many of you are really frustrated with how many times people just send you a link before they've even had any kind of conversation with you? Most people don't like it. And I have never joined anything when I'm just given a link and I'm never talked to in any other way, unless there's been a relationship there already. And that's really the truth with everybody. We don't like it when people give us a link. Now, I'm in lots of groups, lots of companies that I'm part of. And I can tell you right now, whenever somebody gives me a link without talking to me and taking the time to find out who I am and what I'm about, it's a turnoff. It's just a turnoff. I can tell you that. And it doesn't matter how nice your product is, how good it is, whatever. People don't like to get links in their emails or their chat windows. And if you're still doing that, I can promise you that the good ones, the people that are really going to produce, are not going to go with that. We want to have relationships. It's very, very important. So that's what I wanted to share with you. Think about always giving value first. Be willing to talk to people. Actually find out what they're about. Maybe even ask some questions. When you do that, people feel like you care. And guess what? This guy got to the point where I was even interested in looking at his samples, because I'm actually love to have things that help in a natural way to give me more energy. And that's what he was offering. And every time somebody just spams me, which is what it is, when you give a link to somebody without their permission, it's considered spam. So think about how you can create curiosity. Think about how you can actually make somebody attracted to what you have to share, because you're not necessarily giving them all the information right up front. Why don't you wait till they ask for it? And when they ask for it, you're probably going to get a better response. And you're probably going to get somebody that says yes. And isn't that what you actually want? You want somebody that says yes? And they don't say yes when you just give them a link. But they might if you give them just enough information to be a little bit curious and be friendly about it and don't be pushy. That's how I like to handle things anyway. I don't want people to feel like they're pushed into something, and I used to do that, believe it or not. And it's just a big turnoff. So let's all think about how we can not share our links all over Facebook or anywhere else and bring people to us the right way. When we do that, we have a friend that stays with us. How do you think that happens? It's because you were interested in them instead of them having to hear about your business before they even show any interest in it. People just don't go for that. And they're more and more skeptical as days go on. So the more we just throw our links around, the more we're going to just turn people off. So let's do it a different way. Let's invite people in a friendly way without pushy and without giving them a link, waiting until they ask for it. And then when they ask for it, then of course, give it to them. But make sure that they actually want it and they're actually going to look. That's how I want to handle things with anybody I talk to. And that's the only way they'll ever get me to be interested in anything they have. If you found this of value, I would love it if you like, comment, and share. And if you want to learn about some fun ways to make money, let's have a private talk. Bye for now.